Hey guys, welcome to Mech-Dickel Robotics. I just received the new PCBs that will be used to make the Mech-Dickel logo robot, but we'll talk about this little buddy the other day, because the focus of this video is a tutorial to help beginners to design custom cool look PCBs using Inkscape to design the shape and fritzing to make the schematic. I will also show how to order the PCBs from the professional manufacturer JLC PCB and how to assemble and solder the components. So let's start the work. First we use Inkscape to design the shape for the PCB, importing the drawing of the brain from Mech-Dickel's logo. Then create a rectangle where later we will place the pin header of the board with rounded corners. With the draw bezier curves and straight lines tool, draw segments of brain outline. Then, with the Edit Paths by Nodes tool, bend the segments. Now that imported drawing can be deleted. Select together the rectangle and the brain outline and on the path menu, click on Union. Resize the drawing to the actual board size. Before proceed, we have to make an adjust in the preferences. The simplification threshold should be set to minimum. Now in the path menu, click on simplify. Now we have to create two sublayers of the layer 1. One named as board. And the other as silkscreen. The silkscreen layer should stay above the board layer. Now we cut the drawing from layer 1 with Ctrl X and paste it in the silkscreen layer with Ctrl V and paste again in the board layer. Now we'll do some edges in the fill and stroke. First for the drawing in the silkscreen layer. The silkscreen shouldn't have fill. The stroke paint should be white or 255 on the RGB values. And in the stroke style, change the unit to inches and set it to 0.008. Now the drawing in the board layer. Its fill should be green. And it should not have stroke. Now we select both drawings. And in the Align and Distribute, click on Center on Vertical Axis. And then Center on Horizontal Axis. So we go to File and Document Properties, click on Resize Page to Content and Resize Page to Drawing or Selection. Now you'll use the XML editor to make maybe the most important settings, that is change the ID of the board layer and name it as Board and hit Set. And change the ID of the silkscreen layer naming it as silkscreen, and hit set. We also have to change the path ID of the drawing in the board layer, naming it as board outline, and hit set. The last step with Inkscape is to save the file, and it should be saved as plain SVG. Now we'll use Fritzing in the PCB view. Click in Load Image File to load the image made with Inkscape. And start placing the parts, for example, the pin header. We can hide this silkscreen, rotate. And set it to 8 pins. Now we place a resistor. And the LED. Set it to 3 millimeters. And make the routing. With all the components placed, we check if is everything well traced. And the last step with Fritzing is export the Gerber files. Here is the folder with the Gerber files, exported with Fritzing, and it must be in a compressed folder. Now we go to jlcpcb.com and click in Code Now. Upload the compressed folder. And if is everything okay with files, the board will be shown on this page. And here we can choose the quantity, thickness, color, surface finish, and a few more options. Here we choose the shipping method. And then click in Save to Cart. Here you log in or create your account. Logged in, go to Cart. And click Checkout securely. Here you confirm the shipping and choose the payment method. Then click Continue to finish the payment and place the order. The manufacturing is very fast, and after a few days I received the PCBs by mail in my workshop. The boards are really cool. And they have an excellent finish. So, let's assemble it. It just needs 8 LEDs, 8 resistors, and pin headers. Start by placing and soldering the LEDs. Cut the long legs of the LEDs. Next step is solder the resistors, but first bend its legs to make easier to place them. Twist the legs together to keep the resistors in place. The last step of the soldering work is to solder the pin headers. If you don't have a third hand, you can use a piece of tape to keep headers in place while soldering. And the PC brain is finished! Now, we attach it to a Nuno board, and let's make it work. Open Arduino IDE. And upload the code. And it blinks like brain synapses. That's all, guys. Thanks for watching and stay tuned for more PCBs and robot projects.